Hello and welcome. Thank you so much for joining me on PM Live, taking the health theme as we always do every Tuesday. And to check you in on the show today, let me throw this connect question at you. How can the problem of drug abuse be managed in Uganda? For your feedback, go to Facebook at Urban Television, Twitter at Urban TV Uganda, or you can tweet me directly at Raz Athman. Use the hashtag PM Live. I'm Razia Athman. Welcome aboard. Ensuring excellent products, Stafford University Kampala lecturers get training on quality assurance. Shifting waves, a look at how the medical course is changing with time. We have Professor Moro Emmanuel, a surgeon, and the Faculty of Medicine Dean at Gulu University with us. And for sport, bringing the South African talent to Uganda, we meet John Duncan, the coach of the Uganda Rugby Cranes, ahead of the 2nd July game against Namibia. PM Live. Even with the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Control Act of 2015 and the anti-tobacco law that are in force, drug abuse remains a big challenge in Uganda. Members of the Uganda Youth Development Link have appealed to government to come up with a single comprehensive control method against substance abuse. They argue that it is difficult to enforce these laws that are scattered yet dealing with one problem.
Drug abuse accounts for many mental illness cases in Uganda. Since September 2015, the Narcotic Drug and Psychotropic Substance Control Act of 2015 and the Anti-Tobacco Law have been enforced, but cases are still rising. Drugs like marijuana, bhang, and tobacco are still easily accessible in Uganda. In university environments, the youth are crying out for support.
And most especially the girls who go get high with drugs and get unwanted pregnancies, they end up aborting, finally most of them die.
So I would really encourage anyone who is doing in fighting against drugs to keep it up.
Once the government has stopped the drug issue, they are able to work upon their future.
The senior counselor at Uganda Christian University explains how bad drug abuse can get.
Eventually you may not be able to function well. And especially if you're in school, you may not be able to, never be able to complete your academics.
The approach to manage the drug abuse problem can change. The Uganda Youth Development Link has suggested that government comes up with a law that will comprehensively curtail drug users. They want drugs, alcohol, and tobacco to be treated as the same problem.
When you find one person using drugs, remember there are many. There are many around who are using drugs.
Under the theme, Listen First, they're arguing for prevention of drug use that is based on science. That makes it effective in handling the problem. This report by Rachel Nakagolo for PM Live.
And to maintain sober minds, Stafford University Kampala has taken it a notch higher. They've trained their lecturers on quality assurance, an element that lacks in many institutions of higher learning in Uganda. Their aim is to produce the most competent professionals.
It's a training in which lecturers are being taught instead of students. They hired the services of quality assurance manager Bruce Sheppy, who is based in the United Kingdom. The lecturers were helped to set up quality controls that will help them train students better.
Our quality assurance is about confidence that international standards are being met in the delivery of the academic programs here at Stafford University.
It will require a lot of monitoring the way staff are delivering in class.
And there is a lot to expect from the students who will be taught according to the UK standards. How well the lecturers deliver will depend on how fast they learn and whether they can practically apply skills taught.
Us, we shall get it as a secondary information, which is going to help in our lives as we pursue this, as I pursue this master's degree.
It is surely going to work out, because our exams, first of all, are going to be moderated in the UK, and it's going to be a UK standard.
Reports indicate that Ugandan graduates are the least employable in East Africa. Efforts like these are meant to make such graduates more qualified. This report by Rachel Nakagolo for PM Live.
How about we look at those training to become doctors? Things are changing in medical schools across universities in the country, but for better or worse, the course remains among the most prestigious, as Professor Moro Emmanuel, the Faculty of Medicine Dean at Gulu University, told our reporter Benson Ongong.
When he went to medical school at Makerere University, there were only 45 in the whole academic year.
And the training was very, very high quality. And the people who qualified from Makerere were world-class doctors who could work anywhere in the world.
But today, Professor Moro Emmanuel in his own faculty has up to 100 students at Gulu University. This is one of the changing forces in medical schools that is now enlarging the student-to-lecturer ratio. Professor Moro, who has formerly worked with the Ministry of Health and is a surgeon by profession, admits that brain drain presents a hurdle in the development of the health sector in Uganda.
Sometimes the facilities are dilapidated. They don't have proper housing. And they don't have amenities that can give the doctor a standard of living that is for a doctor. So all those demotivate doctors, and they actually look for opportunities to work in a better environment. That's another cause of brain drain.
And such forces will always emerge. This report by Benson Ngom for PM Live.
Well, sit tight. We have more coming up on the show, including hashtag regulate border borders. The spearheading team from Makerere University of this campaign to curb reckless motorcycle riding talk about attitudes and targets on living healthy. Plus, find out some of the oldest medical schools in the world in today's Varsity Facts. John Duncan, a South African, has brought his sporting talent to Uganda. The Uganda Rugby Cranes coach says it doesn't matter as long as one is willing to learn the game. He talks to Issa Nakabale about this and so much more ahead of their game against Namibia on 2nd July.
My name is John Duncan. I'm one of the coaches of the Uganda Rugby Cranes. I've been involved with rugby for many years. First as a player, I played rugby up to club level in South Africa. I come from a rugby family. My father played for the Natal Sharks. I think we've all been involved in rugby because it's given us an opportunity to travel. It's given us an opportunity to meet people. I won't forget the 1B tournament that Uganda hosted last year, which was incredible for the country. I think it was a truly wonderful showpiece for Uganda and the country and the people of Uganda. And that was probably my most memorable rugby memory. Last year we had a good year. We won the Elgon Cup and we won 1B. Obviously we're going out to go and do our best and to win 1A. The team gets really inspired when people get down here and there's a bit of national pride behind them. We're not going to focus on what Namibia does. We're focusing on what Uganda can do.
That game will be happening at the Chadondo Rugby Club. That's 2nd July. Now, moving on, more sport for you. Most people think that football is mainly played by men, but the UCU Cardinal is proving this notion wrong. They are the ladies' team for Uganda Christian University. Let's see how gender balance works in sport for the Mukono campus.
Football, basketball, volleyball, tennis, woodball, athletics, and netball are among the sporting disciplines being promoted at Uganda Christian University. Both men and ladies are encouraged to participate. The Lady Cardinal was started in 2006 to keep women football players who have graduated from the university. And they have participated in several tournaments, including FUFA Women Elite League.
And I think this time we are going there to compete for the top position.
In the just concluded FUFA Women Elite League, at the playoffs, Kawempe beat UCU 1-0. But this is no reason for them to relax. The university is providing a platform for the team to develop and attract more players.
We're going to train more harder because I know we have in East Africa games in Rwanda.
With such exposure to the games, the gamers earned confidence. They are looking forward to participating at the East African University Games slated for December 2016 in Nairobi, Kenya. This report by Issa Nakabale for PM Live.
This, turn me up, this is PM Live.
For today's Varsity Fact, we are taking courses in some of the world's oldest medical schools. Now, the University of Turin Faculty of Medicine and Surgery was established in October 1436, and it's based in Turin, Italy. And Leipzig University Faculty of Medicine was established in 1409, that's in Germany. And the oldest medical school in America is the School of Medicine of the University of Pennsylvania, founded in 1765. In Uganda, we go with Makerere University as the oldest. Stick around, more coming up on Living Healthy. And after all, you don't want to miss out on the Waki and Dope for this Tuesday.
Streets is watching.
You are watching PM Live.